All right, first feature of the day, 6 in the morning.
This kind of stuff, you know, so it's cool to ride something different and have the man teaching me how to ride his, you know, his wheelhouse.
I just kind of wish that I was riding my bike too.
Huge bummer.
That would be a little bit more fun. That's not exactly how I saw this going.
We were supposed to kind of do a two-part series of me showing Cam like my favorite stuff in like terrain that's not so familiar to him, and then him showing me his terrain down in Utah. But yeah, I got injured, so that took me out of the game.
Some pretty toes, huh?
Steel-toed flip-flops.
You just coined it. They're my standard work kit unless we start chipping rocks and shit.
The flip-flops can handle it, the bike can.
That's one of like the cooler looking pieces of the trail I've ever seen, you know?
Oh, sick.
My wife would love it. She loves moss.
Traction starts to break a bit, and then you're just kind of like modulating your brakes, and then like a little unweight skipper over that dip there.
Roll it!
That was sick!
It was a little bit faster than I thought it'd be. Oh man.
Absolute legend, buddy. Oh, nice. That was so butter smooth, so chilling.
Thanks for the tour.
Yeah, no worries. That was sick.
You're a good tour guide.
Getting towards the end of a day of shooting with Cam Zink and Squamish, and we did some loamers this morning.
Here in Squamish, spent the morning riding with Pat. He was showing me more of his, his wheelhouse once again. He's a racer kid and he's extremely fast. Now we're kind of more back to Steve's wheelhouse, and we're both kind of out of our element a little bit.
That's gnarly. I mean, just looking down the thing is pretty spicy.
Rolling.
Hell yeah.
It's super chill. Like, once you get in it, you're like, oh, I got it. You know, drop it. Yeah, buddy. You got a little off to the right, huh? That was sick.
Huh. Oh, that was fun. I almost pooed my pants.
You kind of made me poo my pants. You started getting into the cabbage on the right.
Well, I saw that your like back tire kind of landed in it. And it was like a bit more of a straight shot than going to the right. So I was like,
good on you, man. You found the line. That's awesome. I was a little bit, I got a little flicker for you.
Had to take Cam here. It's just too classic of a spot.
Well,
I think
fast,
so.
Fast and loose?
Yeah, totally.
It goes pretty easy, but it's definitely like it's a high consequence one for sure. Just landing on a little rock lily in the middle of a boulder field. So don't go too fast, don't go too slow.
Everything that we've done is high consequence. They're death-defying. Without sounding so corny, they're literally just mess up. You could straight up dive.
100%.
I think when you get older, it's still all in there. You just gotta warm up longer. Death trap.
Well, it's all covered by shrubbery, so if you can't see it, it can't hurt you.
That's a little slow, huh?
Yeah, for me, Cab, it was like, just like super chill trail speeding down to here. And then as soon as I was on, it was like brake release. And then as soon as I, so you could see it like so far in advance, I was like, oh, it's actually not a far gap. So I was like, tap on the brakes and just went for the little bit of a hop over it.
That one felt slow, so I'll go a tiny bit faster and race her if I have to. That run out is
yeah,
so
buddy. Oh, that was so sick.
Dude, I felt like I did it as perfect as you possibly could, and the run out's still ridiculous.
It's so stupid. Dude, that was like the most perfect landing possible. That was like as clean as I've seen it done. Like cool. you touch down like 2 inches post, and then just like absolutely grease just past the little like flatter section of the knuckle. It was very sick.
It's an honor and a privilege to like be able to just rip around. And you're like, yeah, dude, ride this. This is how fast you go. This is what happens here. And I'm like, sweet, thank you. You
know? Yeah.
Utmost gratitude.